Hey you, welcome back. Today we are going to talk about 5 tips to being Comicon ready. All right, so I'm sure you have seen all of my lovely little plant babies behind me. I am trying to get seeds started for my garden outside, so just ignore them, although they are cute. I call them my babies. Anyway, moving on. So today I've got 5 tips for you that will help you prep for going to a convention. These are kind of specific to the comic book cons and the like, but there are lots of different kinds of conventions out there, and I'm sure that a lot of these tips will apply to just about any of them. So my first tip is to make lists. Now, this is lists of everything. I'm a list person. I list a lot of things out, not just in my writing. As I've talked about in the past, I'm a planner. I also make lists when it comes to traveling. I make lists for what I'm packing. I make lists for my cosplays. I make lists for places I want to visit or restaurants that are close to our hotel. And I personally love this right here. It's called the List Journal. I found this at a local store. I can't remember what store, but I love this journal. So this is a new one for me this year. So it's still kind of, it's short, but it gives you a place where you can list what list is on each page. And then it's got all these different kinds of list things you can make. So I've actually filled in some of mine right here for my cosplay lists and items that are to-do lists for those. So I highly suggest getting some kind of place to keep your lists and to make lists for the things that you are packing and bringing with you. I also recommend getting a folder and putting print-offs of different information that you need for your trip, especially if you're going out of town for a convention. Bring maps that you've printed off of the internet for like places that are nearby, places you want to go, maps that are from your hotel to the con if you can't walk. You know, just keep it all in one folder. That way you have everything in one place. You know, print off your hotel reservations. Print off anything that has to do with the trip. Anything you could possibly need. Print it off and put it in a folder. And that way you know where it's at and you can keep it. You can put your lists in here too. Item number 2 is specifically for cosplayers. I highly suggest before you go to a convention or you go to something where you're cosplaying, you do a full dry run of your cosplay. That is, you put everything on. You do your makeup, you do your hair, you do your outfit, you do all of your accessories, and wear it around your house or to a store or somewhere. Wear it for about an hour to see how it feels, to see if you need to make adjustments, to see if maybe you have too many accessories, to see if your shoes are comfortable. We'll talk about that a little bit more later. Just do a dry run of everything. That way, when it's time to go to the con, you are prepared and you know what to bring and what not to bring, what works and what doesn't work for your cosplay. Now, I learned about this one the hard way because I had a Fallout cosplay that I wore to Planet Comic Con a couple years ago. Well, 4 years ago, I think, and it had way too many accessories on it, and I didn't do a full dry run of all of it. I had done dry runs of each piece, like individually as I was building them, but I did not do a dry run of all of it, and it got to the point that there were so many accessories, and I loved all of them, and I didn't want to let any of them go, that I didn't. And so when I was in the cosplay, I couldn't go to the bathroom. I had a hard time sitting down. It was very heavy. And so I really only was able to stay at the con in that cosplay for about 5 hours before I had to just like cut and run. And I went back to the hotel, I changed my clothes. Fortunately, we were close enough that I could walk back and spend a little bit more time there, but it was a little upsetting because the last like 2 or 3 hours, I was really uncomfortable because I needed to go to the bathroom and I wanted to sit down and all this other stuff, but I just couldn't with all of the accessory pieces on my cosplay. Tip number 3 for being con ready is to keep personal items on your person. Now, that means not in a purse, not in a wallet, not in something that is obvious, especially if you're cosplaying. Make sure you keep your ID, your debit card, and at least some of your cash in a place that's going to be unorthodox. I try really hard to build a storage place for my personal items. Again, my ID, my debit card, and a little bit of the cash I'm carrying, if not all of it. somewhere into my cosplay that's not going to be easy to grab and go. You will find that conventions are very tightly packed, and if someone is a very good pickpocket and they know where to look for your money and your ID and that kind of stuff, they will get it, and you won't even notice until it's too late. So try really hard to keep those things separate from like your purse or your wallet, because those are the things they're going to go for. They're going to look for your purse. They're going to look for your wallet. But if you put it, say, for a long time, I put stuff inside my boots, or I put it somewhere that it's very, very close to my physical body, not just in a pocket. That way, if someone is messing with it, I will feel it. My Fallout cosplay that I talked about earlier, I had a little pocket area right in here that I would stuff that stuff into, and it was pressed up against my chest. So I would notice if someone was trying to reach inside my shirt and grab my stuff, one would hope. But so that's my third tip, is to just keep your important items on your physical person, not in a bag, not in a pocket. Tip number four is to wear comfortable shoes. Now, if you are cosplaying, this can sometimes be difficult, especially if you're like me and you like to try to keep your cosplay authentic. Finding comfortable shoes sometimes is difficult, but I highly suggest, if you're planning on being at the convention for any extended amount of time, make sure that you wear shoes that you can do that in. This is one thing I've never really struggled with, because I've always been a big proponent for wearing comfortable shoes that fit the situation. So I have never had this problem, but my sister had this problem. She wore some sandals to a con because she felt that they matched with her outfit really well, and her feet hurt. Her feet hurt after about an hour of being at the convention, and we had to walk back to the hotel so she could change her shoes and put on tennis shoes and then come back. And there's nothing wrong with that, but that was time missed out on the con, and her feet did kind of hurt the rest of the day because of these sandals that she wore. So if at all possible, even if you're cosplaying, wear the most comfortable shoes you can without sacrificing the authenticity of your cosplay. And I promise you'll think of something. Just try to be creative and come up with something that's a half between being comfortable and meeting your needs for your cosplay. Tip number five is to stay hydrated. Oftentimes, a lot of these conventions are at places that have water fountains. So if you really don't want to pay the like crazy con price for bottled water, stop by water fountains regularly. Stay hydrated. You're doing a lot of walking around a lot of people. It's going to be warm, especially if you're wearing a heavy cosplay. Stay hydrated. Drink water, because the last thing you want is to be that person who blacked out at a convention because they weren't drinking enough water, or that go one day and then can't go the next day because they are dehydrated and not feeling well. So stay hydrated, drink water. If you can, work a water bottle of some kind into your cosplay. I have a canteen, I can't find it. I don't know what I did with it, but I'm gonna keep looking for it. I have a canteen that I'm using with this cosplay for this Planet Comic Con that's coming up that I'm gonna carry, and it's gonna have water in it to keep myself and my friend who's cosplaying with me hydrated, because it's important. Stay hydrated. Make a point of drinking water. Bonus tip. So my bonus tip for this is, especially if you are traveling from out of town, bring medicine. Even if it's just one of those little pill cases that you put a couple of different kinds of medicine in, bring medicine with you. Nothing is worse than traveling around a city that you don't know, trying to find painkillers for a headache because you're dehydrated, and heaven forbid, you should get a fever. You're out there at the con, you're touching all these people, you're getting all these germs. What if you wake up one morning and you're sick and you have a fever and you have no medicine for it? Bring some medicine. Even if it's just the basics, bring just whatever works for you to help you kind of get through something if you get sick. Bonus tip. So if you are cosplaying and you plan on bringing with you some kind of weapon, sort of like this, a prop weapon, make sure that you are abiding by whatever con you're going to's weapon policy. A lot of cons anymore will not let you bring in guns that have any kind of action to them. So this weapon, even though it is obviously not real, weapon, it's a toy, and it's got the orange cap on it. Last time I brought it to a con, I was not able to take it in. I had to check it and put it in a locker and pay for them to hold it for me because I couldn't I couldn't bring it in because it has this action down here. Like, you can see the action. It's just noisemaker, but it was enough that they were like, no, it has moving parts, and therefore you cannot bring it in. So make sure you check their weapons policy. All right, that's all I have for you today. I hope that you enjoyed this video and that you found a tip or two to help you next time you go out of town for a convention. If you did like this video, take this moment to subscribe and ring that little bell so that you'll be notified next time I upload a video, which I try for once a week, although it's been kind of rough recently trying to get ready for the convention. I've been really busy, but then you'll know. And as always, thank you very, very much for being here. I appreciate every single one of you. Bye.